into the streets of Houston here, the Houston Rockets here, guys. Oh man, this team is bad. They're getting 6.5 points here at the house versus the Utah Jazz. Over and under sitting at 230.5. They have covered both meetings this year versus the Jazz. I can say I'm not laying points with the Jazz on the road. I'm not even laying points with them at the house. But man, I don't know if I can get there with the Rockets. Josh, what do you think? They do get Jayshon Tate back in this one, so they're getting some getting healthier. May not have Gordon here. That should be good for them. But how are you looking at the Rockets in this one, Josh?
Yeah, I can't say I've paid a lot of attention to this game. I think that, like you said, the Jazz laying 6.5 on the road seems a pretty big stretch. They're not a team that's performed very well at all as favorites on the road this season. But the Rockets, I mean, you can't really trust them to cover anything. They can be up double digits and they could still, you know, fail to cover this number in the fourth quarter alone. So if you like the Rockets, maybe a first half look, probably the best look at home here to come out and, you know, be competitive early before the wheels sort of fall off for them. I do like the under here. You look at the two meetings before this season so far between these two teams, comfortably under this number. And I think that you dive into a little bit more of the schematics here, and Houston's defense matches up pretty well with what Utah tries to do offensively. You know, they love spacing the floor. They're a team that averages almost 43 pointers a game. The Rockets are really aggressive in their closeouts, really aggressive in their rotations as well to try and funnel teams towards the rim. The Jazz a little bit reluctant to take that avenue when it does present itself. So I think we end up with one of those games where a lot of contested shots from both teams here, because exact same at the other end of the floor where Houston are either taking threes or attacking the rim, and they're the two areas that Utah seem to defend at an above average rate. So I think this number is really, really inflated. Haven't got involved yet. I just want to see and make sure exactly who's playing tonight, just given that, you know, on a back-to-back, we have seen a lot of funny shenanigans close to tip-off. So I'll wait to see what the lineups say, but I'm probably going to get involved in an under here, especially at such a high number.
That's the name of the game these days, man, the NBA. Wait, we got to see who's playing first, man. But, yeah, the Rockets on a back-to-back. I don't think they have to submit their injury report until the 6 p.m. Eastern one here, Skee. Yeah. But Skee doesn't care. He said he doesn't care what the spread is. This is the Houston Rockets we're talking about. And he's saying he's fading them at every chance he gets, Skee. What are we doing in this one, my guy?
To what you were saying, the witching hour in the NBA starts before the game. It's all the injury report all day long. But, yeah, I got to roll with the Jazz in this game. And I get it. They haven't been great as a favorite, but they're favorite for a reason here. I'll start off with this. Road favorites off four straight losses. They are 148, 97, and 6. That's 60.4% against the spread. That goes all the way back to 1995. So that's a league-wide system. It's not team-based. It's every team in this situation. And if the opponent is on a back-to-back, it's up to 67.5% against the spread. Looking at the Rockets, they are bottom three offensive and defensive rated team the last five games on the season. They're bottom 10 shooting and defending the three. They're just terrible. I mean, obviously Utah recent performance stats, the ones I care about, offensive rating, defensive rating, rebound percentage, they're all going to be better the last five games than the Rockets, and they shoot the three better and also defend the three better. So that's how you win by margin. You got the rest advantage and everything is lining up for me to take the Jazz minus the 6.5. Other than that, I do like something about the Rockets. It'll be a player prop. I'll roll with Şengün, and we're going to do his – there's a few ways I think you could bet him, but I'll rock with his points and rebounds. Number I got was 21.5, and a few reasons why I like him. Well, he averages 22.8 on a season, but when he's facing these bottom 10 defenses as far as protecting the paint, he's averaging 26.7, and I think he's gone over 7 out of those 8 games. So – it bodes well for him tonight because Utah, you know, allows the most points in the paint in the league. And bigs versus Utah so far this season, I have them averaging 27.5 points and rebounds. So give me Şengün over to 21.5 points plus rebounds, but also give me the Jazz minus the 6.5.
Okay, I got you. You fade the team, but you like a prop on them as well. But we know that Şengün, hey, he can go for 22 points in this one, my guy, as well. So let's hope that he plays and they don't end up sitting out everybody in this one. But my guy, Skee, rocking with the Jazz, minus 6.5 in this one. And also Şengün, I always struggle with his name, over 21.5, just points and rebounds, guys. So if you like, maybe the PRA might hit as well if that one hits. But like the looks in that one, Skee, definitely some good looks. And that one definitely should be plenty. Should be at least enough points to get you there.